Hey guys, welcome back to TexConnect, a learning center for textiles. Today, we will be starting with a new machine, next in the series after Blowroom in the spinning mill. That is a carding machine. Carding is very important machine in the spinning line. Usually, it is said that the card is the heart of the spinning mill and well card is half spun. At the end of this video, we will understand why it is said so. So now, let us have a look at the passage of carding to have a gist about the process and understand it better. As we know that the material is delivered in the form of a lap on the conventional blowroom line and in the form of fiber tufts from the shoot feed in modern blowroom lines. So this tufts or lap is presented in the sheet form to the assembly of feed roller and the feed plate. The feed roller then presents this bag to the licorin. Licorin is a saw-toothed roller. Here, the licorin opens the fiber into small tufts, and also a lot of impurities are eliminated here with the help of dirt eliminating devices and suction present underneath it. So licorin basically helps in opening and cleaning. The licorin then presents these tufts to the main cylinder. The main carding action, that is fiber to fiber separation, takes place in the carding zone, that is between the cylinder and the flats. Here, the fibers are parallelly arranged, but to form a cohesive web, they need to be entangled. So, the doffer collects the fiber from the cylinder in such a way that a cohesive web is formed. The doffer further delivers the web, which is then condensed to form a sliver. Don't worry, we will be learning each part in detail in the upcoming videos. Now, let us move forward towards the objectives of card. The most important objective is opening into individual fibers. In the blowroom, the fibers are opened into tufts. There may still be impurities that may be adhered to the fiber, and their elimination is only possible when the fiber is individualized. Also, to reduce the entanglements and provide a good orientation, this individualization is done. The next objective is elimination of impurities. As we have seen in the passage, the majority of elimination of impurities takes place in the licorin region. The modern cards have a very high degree of cleaning. The modern blowroom and carding combined have a degree of cleaning as high as 95 to 99%. This is a very high degree of cleaning percentage. The third objective is elimination of dust. On a blowroom and card, the free dust that is present is eliminated by the suctions present. However, microparticles that are bound to the fibers require fiber to fiber or fiber to metal friction to loosen such particles. This type of friction is available on the carding machine. This is how dust is eliminated. The fourth object is disentangling of neps. One of the disadvantages of blowroom is that due to vigorous treatment, the number of neps increases from machine to machine in the blowroom line. Carding reduces this to a very small fraction. However, it is falsely assumed that carding eliminates these neps. Instead, these neps or entanglements are opened up by the carding machine. This is why we say disentanglement of neps and not elimination of neps. The next object is fiber blending. The carding does not improve the long-term blending, but as each fiber is individualized, the fiber-to-fiber blend and transverse blend is good. But blending at carding is not very popular. However, it is used sometimes. And in industries, blending at blowroom and blending at draw frame is preferred. The next objective is fiber orientation. It is often said that fibers are parallelized on a carding machine. However, this is not justified, because the fibers in the web are not parallel. the fibers obtain somewhat parallel orientation on the cylinder, but the parallel orientation disappears due to the formation of web. However, a longitudinal orientation is obtained for the first time. Hence, we can say that the card has a task of partial orientation. The next objective is elimination of short fibers. This is not one of the main functions of a carding machine. But during the carding process, the longer fibers remain on the cylinder surface and a very small amount of small fibers are pressed into the flats, which are then eliminated as flat strippings. A carding machine eliminates only 1 to 2% of flat strippings, out of which 50% is short fibers. So the short fibers removed by carding is less than 1%, and that is negligible. That is why we say that removal of short fibers is not a main function of a carding machine. The last object of a carding machine is the formation of sliver. To transport and process the material further, a suitable product needs to be formed, and that product is sliver. If you have seen the spinning overview video, you must be knowing what is a sliver. Now, why the carding is the heart of spinning mill? It is because of all the tasks that it performs. It determines the quality of the yarn that we will be spinning. If the material is carded well, then we will get a good quality yarn from it. And hence, it is known as the heart of spinning. So that is all from the first part of the carding process. We will be coming up with more videos very soon, in which we will be explaining each part individually in detail. Until then, stay tuned and stay connected. And also, don't forget to like the video, share it with all the textile people you know, and subscribe to TexConnect, a learning center for textiles.